What are the three main reasons embedded software is developed with model-based approach? Hello, my name is Nabile, Khoury from Paris, and I want to discuss this topic with Markus, Gros from Berlin. Hi, Markus.
Hi, Nabile. And I have to say, the Eiffel Tower looks really funny tonight.
Yes, and I don't see any Haussmannian building around. The reason is because we are in Tokyo, and this is the Tokyo Tower.
Yeah, amazing to be with you in Tokyo. And sure, let's directly start with reason number one. And I call this the higher abstraction level. So if we look a little bit at the history of embedded software development, especially in automotive, we can see that long time ago, maybe early 90s, software was developed in assembler. And then the complexity was growing. People said, no, this language is too close to the machine, yes, too far away from the human brain. We need a higher abstraction level, and people started using C code. And of course, they needed a translator, an automatic translation to object code, which was the compiler. But it did not stop there. The complexity continued to grow, right?
Indeed. In the early 2000s, the complexity of the embedded software was growing again, and engineers needed a solution which was even closer to the human brain and which was graphic, like Simulink and Stateflow. But then again, they needed something to translate the graphical language into C code, and that's where the code generator was introduced.
Yes, and it doesn't stop there, because the complexity challenge is also introducing another problem. It's very hard to find guys and engineers who master the whole process. So thanks to model-based development, we can now have a divide and conquer approach and separate the concerns. We can have engineers, function developers, and they develop the Simulink model with their domain knowledge, and then they pass it on to another team which has probably less domain knowledge but more software knowledge,
hardware
about
knowledge,
hardware
constraints,
data types,
sections,
yeah,
types,
you name it, yeah, and then take the model and develop the software out of it.
Yes, but there's also a third reason, and last but not least, the model brings a lot of advantages because it can help to find issues very earlier in the development process, because it can be simulated, can be used to do rapid prototyping, and this improves the quality of what is being developed afterwards in production.
Yeah, absolutely. So these were our three reasons for doing model-based embedded software development. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and follow us on LinkedIn or YouTube for more videos.
Thank you.